Okay, let's see. I'm testing my microphone for now. Let's just see. Wait until this loads. Yeah, YouTube is up. And Twitch is coming online, is it? I'm not sure. Yeah, Twitch is coming online.
Well, yeah.
And Mixer, whoever watches Mixer, is also on. How about you? Can you?
Yeah, I can see it. Yeah, I can see it.
Okay. Let me just. Okay. Both of our voices are being heard. That's good. I just wanted to test that.
That's good.
Okay, yeah. So let's start. Good day, everybody. This is Doppel Gameplay Videos, and joining me tonight is
Dev Gaming. Hey guys.
And today we're back with more Raid World. In the last part, it was a total failure because we just got eaten over and over and over.
Did you make the montage yet?
Oh right, I forgot about that. But I'll totally do that right about now. Well, after this, rather. Everybody knows, get it. Oh crap, it's a zero gravity. Ah, completely out of control. Okay. I need that rock. And a spear. Okay, if I remember correctly, I don't want to go down there.
Yeah, they go the same way, either way. It's just once. They're both actually about the same difficulty.
Let me just
being quiet.
Okay, let's see. According to the map, we definitely want to go north. I do remember having a better time going up north.
Yeah.
Watch out for the disgusting.
So I'm trying to get an end card made, but I got someone who can do the animation, but I'm waiting to find if I can find someone who can do the music.
Yeah.
Because I don't even need that, like, a whole thing. I just need, like, 15 seconds worth.
Yeah, I sort of wanted to do that sort of stuff too, but I don't know why I don't. I guess it's just,
why not?
I guess it's just that having art set up, having music set up adds extra complexity. Oh, crap! Okay, I did a gravity slingshot.
Well, Nappa's all the same end card all the time. I mean, Markiplier, and so they usually use the same music in end card.
Yeah, I suppose.
And Jacksepticeye had one for like years. He only recently updated it to something new.
Yeah, same as Zeta. Doom. He's not as popular.
And I want to do something like that because it's kind of annoying to have to time my end cards. Time the ending of the stream so that I don't cut myself off.
Yeah.
I think it's like 4 or 5 seconds.
Yeah, approximately.
I'd rather end the stream with the end card.
Okay, let's see. If I remember correctly, I want to grab that pole, which I totally missed. Okay. Gonna shimmy up this way. Slight pulsing of music. Come on.
Gotta time it better.
Yeah. Oh crap, I'm completely on the sideways vector.
You're not quite there yet, just grab something.
Okay.
Not that one, go on the next one.
Hold on for a moment, I need to reposition.
Oh, never mind. Okay, it's kind of there. It's gotta get up there.
Ah, crap! I put a little vector. Put a little spin to my- Oh, crap!
He doesn't know you're there yet. He just sort of like found where you kind of were. There's a thing, this little tentacle's right there, so be careful.
Yeah, I noticed.
And you go shooting upwards. Oh no! Oh, you did the thing. You did the thing.
I got eaten again.
Yeah, the cycle continues.
Sorry, what were you saying?
I said, and the cycle continues.
Yummy tummy filling.
Someone asked me to play Mario Kart Double Dash, but if I do play that, I'm gonna play it where we can play it together.
Yeah, we can netplay stuff now. And I could use my Engine X thingy, so I could, so you don't have to use, you don't have to stream and load up your internet with the bandwidth.
Yeah.
Oh crap. Okay. Nice position.
How does he not get sick from doing the spins?
He might be just a cat.
A slug cat.
Yeah. Okay, let's wait for the gravity to turn back off. Ah, come on. That works. Okay, down we go. Crap!
Good job, Doppel. Good job.
Thank you.
You went right in its hands. Good job.
Stop.
That takes some quite precision.
I was trying to do a gravity slingshot. The same technique is used by actual spacecrafts to escape the solar system, by the way. Oh crap! they slingshot around the moon's gravity after they leave Earth. Apparently the moon orbits the Earth like thousands of miles per hour. And if you get your spaceship just right in the moon's orbit, you can use the moon's gravity to slingshot yourself without using any gas.
Interesting.
Yeah. Speaking of which, another simulator game that I want to actually try is Kerbal Space Program. Have you heard of it?
Yes.
Yeah, it's like
it's
very
kind of hard.
Very accurate astrophysics sim.
You should also try the Universe Sandbox game. It's actually pretty cool. I just got bored real quickly of it because
yeah, it's technical.
I just don't really like. I don't play simulators that much anymore. I used to play those games for hours, but I have to really be in the mood for them.
Mm-hmm.
And when I have so little free time, I don't really want to play them.
Same.
But you might like it because it's really technical and a lot of fun. If you have an idea what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I was trying to create a solar system with two stars sort of rotating around each other. But it wouldn't work very well.
Yeah, the binary star system. I heard a gravitation on those. Just has to be. I didn't time it correctly. This has to be right.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Why did you grab that?
I mean, it kind of worked.
Hey! God damn it! And so the cycle continues of getting eaten.
Yeah, I wonder what the criteria would be for a living a planet that can sustain life in a binary star system.
I have zero idea.
Yes, whole according there's this the ending of season 5 of the 100 basically involves such a thing, and it got me interested.
I haven't watched the 100. Like,
oh, you really should.
Yeah. I can barely finish. Really oh, good. Crap! I can barely finish Naruto here. Gravity slingshot! Ah, crap! Okay, let's not.
And you messed it up.
Oh, no, I did swing upwards, like half rotation, but not the full rotation I wanted.
Because you grabbed onto it.
Yeah. Okay, let's go this way. Let's just position ourselves right and not get eaten. Just to answer the video's title, will we get eaten again? The answer to that is yes. Yes, we will get eaten again.
We've already gotten eaten again. That, Grande Longlegs probably fat by now.
Yeah, very fat. Let's just position ourselves just accurately.
I just like to imagine the Slugcat in that one moment sort of freaking out and face punting the pole.
Yeah. So the US Air Force actually did an experiment with animals in zero gravity. Cats. Hell yeah. Just panic and trash around.
Wait, is there like videos of this anywhere?
Yeah, there is videos on this on YouTube. It is public domain. It was made in the 1960s. But yeah, I do remember seeing it on YouTube a couple of times.
What was the cat doing?
The cat was like clawing at the air, spinning uncontrollably. Okay. At least we're getting.
Was there any more than just the cat?
There were also pigeons. I think they also tested dogs. The pigeons were flying, but they were like totally confused.
I gotta watch this. Okay, I gotta watch this.
Yeah. Okay, let's go have some gravity first. Okay, if I remember correctly, we wanted to go to the left. I want to go to the left. How much time do we have? It's a long day.
I think you have plenty of time.
Yeah. Oh, N-O-P-E. Okay, I want to go to the center. Now let's precision drop.
I think you can land in that middle area.
Yeah, I don't trust it. There's like blue dots everywhere. Okay, I don't like that. Those tentacles are reaching for me.
What are you sort of doing here?
I want to get to the center. Okay, that is safe.
Why don't I sort of just leap forward, like up?
Crap! I put a vector into my jump. Okay, apparently we're going right.
As long as you don't get to the bright blue spots.
Mm-hmm.
Just leap forward.
Oh, come on, that was a little too early. Is it me, or is this gravity cycle getting faster and faster?
Stay away from that spot and just sure bounce off the floor. Don't even grab that thing.
Hello, Samantha Kirk. How are you? Oh, come on, I didn't time that jump properly.
Hello there, Samantha. You can sort of grab it. There you go.
Yeah, nice.
Okay, you're out of the danger zone.
Memory conflicts. Okay, we're out of the danger zone, but we are not out of the time zone, so let's actually go this way. We should find shelter ASAP, unfortunately, or find food ASAP. Ah, crap. Speaking of food, dinner is Serve the. Come back here. Gotcha.
Got one.
Okay, that's all I need to actually sleep. Gotcha. Okay, I need to get that last one. I know it's kind of superfluous, but it is a long day. Ah, I'm out of control.
Just be careful.
Okay, nice. Ah, where are we? Like, is this like permanent zero G? Seems to be like it, right?
Yeah.
Why is that blue tadpole thingy turning red?
It has turned different colors.
Okay. Look at it, it's just chasing me, circling my face.
It's like, you can't get me, you can't get me.
Yeah, come on. Aha! Right into my trap.
Your trap is just floating there waiting for it.
Oh, come on. Okay, let's go south. Let's see if there's any shelter on the map. There isn't. Come on, 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 come on. Yes!
Okay, I'm just watching this video of the cat in zero gravity. He's doing a barrel roll. not a barrel roll, an alien roll. He's just spinning. He's forcing himself to spin.
Okay, this is bad. I went back to the danger zone. Because of course I do. Okay, just have to get up this way. Okay, phew. Okay, I want to go upwards then. So how are you this wonderful evening? I just finished walking my dog actually before I started the stream. Fantastic doggy outside. Fantastic doggy walking weather outside. Oh, come on! Grab onto that thing!
Just there, hold on, just you can get to it eventually.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, grab, grab! I want to jump through there. This looks dangerous. I'll avoid
it. Be careful. Gotta be careful.
Grab the thing! Yes. Okay, and we're gonna go upwards, then left. I'm gonna go around this. Look at the amount of food. We are maxed out.
Yeah, make your way to a sleeping spot now.
I'm using the food throwing dent to give me a little thrust vector.
I couldn't find you for a second there. I was like, where'd you go?
It's just a big wall of white. Oh, come on! I want to avoid that big red thing in the center. Okay, we're running out of time. Give me the wall. Okay, let's go this way. Okay, down we go. Looks dangerously. Ha! Okay, I don't see a sleeping spot anywhere. Yeah. Gotcha. There we go. The red center area looks dangerous, so I am not messing with that.
My favorite part is the cat when he just clings to dear life to the person that she floats to.
Yeah, animals in zero gravity, very interesting.
Actually, the baby chick just sits there and does nothing and just looks around all like, what's going on? And the lizards, which are geckos, they stick to the walls. They don't give a damn.
Gravity? What is
gravity? Like, it's like, oh, this is a thing? Okay, who cares?
I'm drifting closer to the red zone. Notice. Okay. And I'm drifting towards space to that dangerous looking thing. Seriously, where the heck is that sleeping spot?
Just gotta look for it.
Okay. I am way off course.
Where are you trying to go?
A sleeping spot.
Just gotta keep finding, keep going and looking for one.
Okay. And so we go for a big giant thrust vector forwards. Ah! I look like this, we're running out of time. Raid is coming.
What's your time?
2 tips. A single tip.
Look at your time.
We're already the time out.
Wouldn't the rain have come by now?
Whoa, what the heck?
Oh, this is trippy, huh?
Yeah. Okay, we must hurry.
It would have came by now. Look at your time.
0. We are already completely time out.
You would have. Something would have happened by now, though.
Yeah, I know. The controller didn't rumble.
So you should just focus on what you're looking at.
Wow, what the heck is going on here? The music just kicked in too.
Oh yes. I can tell you right now you're completely safe.
Aw, oh, don't ruin attention.
But you want to focus on what you're seeing right now, because nothing's hurting you right now.
Yeah, it is.
In this room you're completely safe, but
I'm just I don't know about
what next after this. So let's keep going.
I'm just floating in space. There's a little exit right there. What the heck? Where am I? What are you? It's another robot girl. What? Yeah. I don't understand. Will you like a silver ball? Don't tell me anything, by the way.
I'm not.
Would you like a purple? Once I say deep throat this black ball, do you like that? What are you saying? I don't understand! I see numerals. What does that mean? Would you like to watch me solo an orange one? There's some sort of map. So I go into this machine thingy. I move it to the left, please. So my brain is kind of important. Whoa, what the? Oh, what the? I have a duck now.
Look at the bottom.
Is this reaching you?
But read faster, because it can't go fast.
A little animal on the floor of my chamber. I think I know what you're looking for. We are stuck in a cycle, a repeating pattern. You want a way out. You know that this does not make you special. Every living thing shares the same frustration. One of my comes in a processing strata to me, who am, if you excuse me, godlike in comparison. The good news first. In a way, I am what you're searching for. Me and my kind have a purpose to solve that very oscillating number that chests of you in the countless others. A strange charity, you the unknown recipient, I the reluctant gift. The noble benefactors, gone.
Is it going when you press a button?
No. The bad news is okay. No definitive solution has been found, and every moment in equipment erodes to a new state of decay. I can't help you collectively or individually. I can't even help myself. For you, though, there is another way. The old path. Go to the west past the farm arrays, and down into the earth where the land fissures as deep as you can reach, where the ancients built their temples and danced their silly rituals. The mark I gave you will let you through. Not that it solves anyone's problems but yours. At the end of time, none of this will matter, I suppose, but it would be nice if you took another way out. One free of frolicking in my memory arrays. There's perfectly good access shaft right here.
Okay, you want to go to the shaft you didn't come from. You want to hurry, because if you linger, you don't want to linger. There you go.
Okay.
So yeah, that was Five Pebbles himself.
The robot, one of the robot girls that are like, so he's like
the map. The location the map is called is actually their name. Like, he is Five Pebbles. The other one is Looks to the Moon.
In that case,
that's
their
actual names.
I should go back to Looks to the Moon.
You could.
I could probably understand her, in quotes, now that I have this little
thing you could do is bring her some more of those neuron flies that you've been eating.
Uh-huh. Oh, come on. Problem?
What? Oh.
I'm completely in a straight vector, unable to reach anything.
The problem, though, is that you have to make sure you don't eat them and make it all the way to her and back, like, several times. But all it really does is give you some extra lore, if you want.
Who doesn't want extra story, right?
It's really hard. You have to basically avoid eating the two neurons you get at a time, and,
Oh, crap, seriously?
You have to go back and forth a few times. Through the, overhang, the one you came through before this.
Okay, in that case, let's go look for somewhere safe to sleep. Because this has been a long day for him.
You can probably do that after you beat the game, because you'll be able to.
Yeah, okay, that's good. Oh, I thought that's a shaft.
Because I personally, I never did it because it was really hard. For just some lore pieces, it's really hard.
Okay, that sounds good.
It's something you can probably do on the side rather than in the middle of the story, because you're going to be at it for a long time.
Okay, let's see.
Alright, you're going to want to go towards those poles on the side there.
Yeah, I'm completely lost. I don't have any control.
Yeah, there's just enough gravity for you to come slowly back down.
Yeah.
Just enough gravity.
I noticed the sidewall is red.
Also, notice how you suddenly have light?
Yeah, luminescence.
Yeah, that's because you ate one of the neuron flies.
Okay, so let's see this mural.
That I think it's just graffiti. I think it gets more clear next time, on the next one.
Okay, I'm trying to like.
I don't know what that is.
Looks like it's like the robot girl, the AI girls.
Yeah, there's some of those symbols. I don't know. I can't tell what it is though.
Yeah, kind of very dark.
I can't tell what's going on here. Oh, there's like two people here.
Yeah, there's two people. Looks like they're worshipping whatever in the center.
It gives me a Buddhist vibe, actually.
It does. That it does.
That gives me a Buddhist vibe.
That it does. Very unclear, though.
It's some lore that's in the background, but I don't really understand it.
Same.
Like that. It's giving you a very Buddhist symbol. That's the neuron flies along the side of it, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, it has two shields and spears. Maybe that's what the scavengers used to be.
It seems to be that. He's shielding himself against spears from both sides.
That's something we can think about later.
Ah! Crap! Well, at least here's a sleeping spot. Finally some progress without being tummy filler.
Finally some progress, yes.
Yeah, finally some progress indeed. Just checking the audio. So, in this cutscene, it just seems to be a replay of what happened earlier.
In 3D.
In 3D.
Yeah, that is spooky. Imagine being the rain cat, the slug cat during this.
Yeah, hold on for a moment. I'm gonna go grab a glass of water.
Okay.
Okay, we're back. We're back. You still there?
Welcome
Lev?
Back.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome back.
X? What?
Yep, your karma's gone up. You're gonna need to keep that max too. There is one thing you could do.
Yeah.
There's gonna be four things called echoes scattered around the entire Rain World map. They will give you lore. And it's called the pilgrimage, and they will give you lore. You can also do that after the main story.
Yeah, let's go do the main story first. You know.
Yeah, I've only found one by accident. And what happens is the second time you sleep in an area, all the enemies will be gone, and everything will start to look trippy. That's when you know there's an echo nearby.
I know it advised, but let's go max out our food right about now.
Yeah. You're not gonna be coming back here soon, so.
Yeah, might as well, right? Soon. Let's go to the left.
Alright, so the farmer race is gonna be all the way back at the beginning. In the outskirts.
Unfortunately but for us.
You can go anywhere else you want for right now, but that's where you're heading towards.
Good to know.
And there's at least one echoes along the way. So you can get a hint of who they are. He might appear on the first time. So keep an eye out.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, you can go now. And also, pay attention to your surroundings. Don't just look at the Slugcat, because you're going to see something that's really cool next.
Okay.
What are you waiting for?
Just checking something.
Oh, okay. I thought you were, waiting for it to load. All right, pay attention, because this is going to be really interesting. It's going to make you think about a lot of theories.
That's kind of the best part, right?
Oh, yes. I wish I streamed this at one when I first played it, because it was amazing. I'm glad I'm here with you on it.
Oh, yeah.
Just whenever you see it, feel free to start spilling your thoughts.
What the? Yep. This looks like New York City, the subways.
Yep.
A really far, far out, far, far future version of it. Look at all the buildings.
There's a lot of buildings, and there's also not a single tree.
Not a single tree. Yeah, it's like a supercharged version of Detroit or something. In fact, I've went to Detroit a couple of times on my trips, and the color scheme is pretty close.
Yeah?
The color scheme is pretty close. Just endless expanse of gray and dilapidated buildings.
What about the surroundings? Isn't there any trees? I've never been outside Texas.
Oh, that is actually surprising.
Yeah, there's not a single tree.
Not a single tree.
Not even any clouds. It's just like barren. It's like a wasteland. So, makes you wonder what happened here.
Yeah, it's like, I think just extreme amounts of pollution just caused a lot of
notice one more thing. Notice how the entire city's blacked out and still.
Yeah, it's possibly pollution.
Yeah, it's all dead.
All dead. Nobody's alive.
It seems dead.
Nobody seems...
At least that's what we can see right now.
Yeah.
Also, you're on a timer.
Oh, crap! Ah! Okay, I think it is about time that we refresh SharePlay, okay?
Okay, yeah.
Because, okay, we'll be right back. We're gonna be changing our SharePlay so that Dev keeps a video stream.
Goes.
Okay, can you speak?
Testing 1, 2, 3. You should be fine.
Okay, we are in fact fine. Let me just check something over here.
Okay.
I think I have to set my OBS monitors. Oh, that's what it was causing that.
Causing what?
Okay, let's just see. Speakers. Okay, I think this should be fine. Okay, let's go down.
All right. So once you go drop down there, there's no way getting back up. Not easily.
I know.
Oh, yeah, you want to notice how look at everything. Look at how warped it looks.
Yeah.
And the music too. That's also an indicator. There's an echo nearby.
Whoa.
Wait, go back.
That looks incredibly dangerous. We can feel your presence, little creature. Your attunement has become much closer to ours. The mark you received is an unimaginable gift. The struggle, the cycles. It can all fade like a morning mist beneath the glory of the sun. We found a way.
Notice how his face looks like one of the murals.
Yeah, it does. Okay.
They just max out your karma. And if you haven't seen Five Pebbles yet, they give you one piece of this extra karma.
Ah.
It's called the Pilgrimage Run. It's like an alternate meth way of playing the game, if you want to do that.
Oh, yeah.
To find all four echoes before you find Five Pebbles.
All right. Oh, hello, Beyond Game. Sorry about that. Why did I get back here?
Yeah, he sort of makes you go back to your previous save. Like, he forces a cycle on you. You don't lose, like, karma or anything, but you do find... He stays in your save file as you found him, but he puts you back to your to the next cycle. You can't drop something. Yeah.
What am I doing? Hello, on Game Animations. Sorry to hear that.
So yeah, you know how I'm sorry about that, Animations. Hopefully something gets fixed or you can get them back soon.
Yeah, it's fine. So what do you say?
Now that you've seen the dead city, do you have any thoughts about why it looks like that?
It looks like severely polluted and messed up.
Yeah. And what about the echo that said we found a way?
They found a way to become immortal or to break the cycle of reincarnation, because Five Pebbles said that the struggle of all living things is that they live the same thing over and over and over. Right?
Yes.
And they
this
want
is, this is the Buddhist idea, the Buddhist belief of reincarnation, where once you die you get reincarnated into either a new person or entirely a new something else entirely. And they basically, the plot of this game based on what they told you so far is that they have found a way to
break the cycle. Yeah.
And that is where you're going to now, is to find out what happened.
Indeed. I'm interested.
And it is the most amazing ending in a game I've ever seen. it is really blows your mind. So be prepared to be awestruck.
I'm just going to be prepared for a fight. Why did I throw my spear?
The heck? Oh yeah, that's a dead end up there. That's just where you get the echo.
Oh yeah, right.
Oops. But yeah, there's also food there you can get.
And there it is. Oh, but I already maxed out on food.
Yeah, you did.
What the? Okay. The wall. Not big and beautiful.
Yeah, there's a way you can go to crawl down that, just so you know. Not like that, but yeah. You could have crawled down the pole.
Like the wall crawl?
What was that on the side there? Did you see that?
What?
Go back. Look on the side there. Go down. Look on the side there. Oh, that's the bats. They're just sort of hugging the wall there.
Yeah, the bats. It's like, I was looking at the right side.
Yeah, I was looking at the left side. Look at them just hugging the wall. Yeah. The edge of the screen. It's like they can't go any further. That's kind of funny. Uh-oh, watch out.
Oh, I just pissed it off.
You gotta hit in the back.
Ah, okay. Sprint. Into the shelter.
All right. Now, what happened to me is when I first played this game, I accidentally ate some of the neurons for Looks of the Moon,
Yeah.
And I ended up killing her.
Oh, fantastic.
But it gave me this glowing light that you have now in order to progress through the to the Shaded Citadel with ease.
Oh, well.
As sort of like, well, that's what you get for it, but yeah.
The wall. The big, beautiful wall. I'm gonna get the spear. Crap!
Don't forget, if they grab you, you can use the spear to make them let you go real quick. You have to be quick.
That was cheap. Unfortunately, I got the lower karma value now.
You have like 4 buffer now before you start getting too far down, but you know, you gotta try and keep it maxed out.
Yeah. Darn it, seriously? That silly lizard got me good. Oh, we got stunned. Move.
He's not chasing you anymore. Oh yes, yeah. He is. Okay.
Oops.
That's the wrong way, but yeah.
I know. I just wanna lose him.
You can crawl through those little holes in the pot and the walls, by the way. The one you were just over?
Yeah.
Yeah, because if you get stuck, you can crawl through the floor in those little open spots.
Hey, a food! Ah. Gotta go do a little loop-de-loop right here.
You just made it come towards you. That was fun.
Yummy. Yummy.
And you're after this one, you're maxed out. Be careful.
I'm gonna get the brick.
I don't want to go that way. I don't think.
Yeah, it looks like a death drop.
Yeah, it was a death drop. So be careful here. Got 2 lizards there.
Oh, sneaky camel one.
That'd be quicker. Gross. Oh, he almost got you there. He almost got you. I don't see a camel lizard. Just be careful what you drop.
Oh,
that was close. Just be careful.
Yeah.
Because you can drop to your death here. Really drop to your death here.
I don't want to go down. Doesn't seem safe.
You have to go down.
Can you jump to the left?
You could, but I think you need to go down.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know how you get up from there, though. Well, I think that actually the left was to go towards the chimney canopy, but you can also go down from here if you want.
We got an orange guy.
Be careful. They come in groups. They will surround you.
Crap!
They will surround you.
Crap!
Okay, wait, he's stuck. Hold on. You need to get into that pipe.
I'm here.
Oh. He's gonna drop with you, so be careful, very fast. He's gonna drop with you.
Oh, come on!
You should have dropped sooner when you can grab the ledge, not the pole.
Yeah, huge mistake.
Thank you.
bolts.
No, you want to be careful. You want to be careful.
Totally. We got the food.
What happened?
I dropped a little hard.
Oh yeah, that happens.
Yep. I just remembered I have to use a D-pad for this. Extra position.
Yeah. You ever been on water slides and you had these, either you or someone else would just sort of sit on this dry spot on the side and stay there just because it could?
No, all our water slides have like fire hydrant, warm out the water going down them. And specifically,
yeah, that was sort of like the ones in the ones I've been to, but there is a few here and there, like one in Galveston, where there is this water slide going down a hill, a really large hill, and it was a lot of fun to slide on. And I personally was one of the people who would find this one dry spot and a turn and sort of just stop where I was at and just sit there for a bit. Just because I could.
Ah, crap. Sometimes you just gotta make a break for it. I'm listening to that.
Yeah, you want to be careful.
What the? Dead end.
No, go straight down. Can you not go straight down?
Oh, yeah, cool.
Oh, yes, okay.
Just have to good torque yourself to get around places.
Yeah.
So what do you think of the Air Force experiments where they put animals in zero gravity?
It was kind of funny.
It is. It was
funny. I wanted to see more than just what they showed, though. I couldn't find another video.
Yeah, it's a pretty old film. I don't think they did dogs.
There was one dog. It was, he just sort of like, it was very chill. He was like, okay, I'm floating here now. It just floats away.
Okay, let's go right. It's a shelter. Go to sleep, baby. Okay, this has been going for almost an hour. Do you need to sleep?
I think I'm okay for a bit if I want to just go a little bit longer.
Yeah, I'd say a little bit longer is fine.
To see where things are.
Going down. So what happens if you stay too long at the five pebbles? Do we go left here?
Well, you can cross his area only about like two times across his little room before he kills you, because he just gets impatient. But you have to go through him like at least two times in order to get the neuron flies to look to the moon. But
wow.
If you stay in his room for too long, just sitting there, he will also just kill you after giving you a few warnings.
Okay, do we go forward this way?
It's up to you.
We want to get back to the starting point, right?
Yes, and everything leads to that eventually.
Okay, let's take this route then. It flickered for a bit.
Yeah, it does that occasionally.
There's one person watching on Mixer and Twitch. Hey there!
Hey!
Oh, popcorn!
Oh, Chimney. Yes.
Chimney Canopy.
Oh, this is the direction to Chimney Canopy. Oh, you're in for a fun one.
Oh, yeah. Okay, let's go down.
This is kind of really hard.
Don't worry, I am the king of clutch. Oh, they're giving us a lot of weapons. There's a good reason for that. Our first challenge.
Getting across that. You might have to go from the top.
Oh, oops, I said a bad word. Go me! And now the entire stream is demonetized. Oh wait, did I go down here? I went up. I went up.
There's more than one way you can go.
I want to go this way because this is the way I chose.
But you can also explore if you want to.
I suppose I want to explore this way.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, the popcorn. We need that food.
Yeah, you want to go this up from the top, I think.
Yeah. Grab the little spear. Doody doody doo, jumping across the thing. Ah, crap! That's our cue to run. Oh, what the?
Oh.
Okay, I will explore. Let's not go there.
You have to do a standing. Do a leap on that one.
Yeah, the little crouch thing, right?
Yeah.
We're losing karma pretty fast.
Chimney Canopy is all about precision jumping.
Balls. Okay, abort. Let's go somewhere else.
I think you can go farther down.
Yeah. I am not worthy of precision jumping. Well, I am pretty worthy of precision jumping, I'm just not accurate enough.
That's fine.
Jumping across the thing. Jumping across the thing.
What's this?
I have no idea. It didn't say anything at the bottom.
I remember. I kind of remember this. I kind of don't. I think I was the one that went down. Like what you're doing now. Because I didn't want to deal with the chimney canopy either.
Yeah.
What's this? I think I remember this. Oh, I know what this is. It is... It is actually... I'll let you know when you see it, but...
Oh, crap.
It's a dead end.
It's a dead end!
You cannot get over there whatsoever. There's no way. Not without very expert controls, if at all. That is a dead end. I remember that now.
Crap.
So yeah, you have to go through the chimney canopy?
Oh, come on!
I couldn't remember if that was where that led, but the kind of violet lights right there gave it away. Yeah. That makes me curious about where that comes from, though.
What comes from?
What leads to this area from there?
Oh, yeah.
It's a one-way trip into the wall.
Okay, let's go back upstairs then. Ah, it's a short day. I gotta go get some food and I go to sleep just to erase karma.
Yeah. We can call it there.
Yeah, and call it that! Or we can go to... Or we can go back to the checkpoint. Through the stomach.
You can always let them drag you there. I don't know why, but the way you said that was just hilarious.
Of course.
You can also, I think you can jump over them. Nope. They might fight for you, but I don't know. Nope, you're dead.
Womp womp. Goody, we have to go karma grinding.
Don't worry, you have a long way to go for that.
Okay, well, if it's been an hour, I think we gotta call this right here.
Okay.
It's been fun. Finally, we made some progress with getting eaten.
Yeah.
Well, in this case, I wish you guys good night, and I hope you... I must have drank something. I'm out of water.
It's okay.
Yeah, well, what do we? How do we end this?
Well, thank you guys for watching.
Yeah.
If you want to support us, please hit the like button, subscribe, and don't forget that bell.
And go to Dev's channel. It's in the video description. He's a nice, cool guy. Anyway, I guess I thank you everybody for going through this wonderful good night with us, and I hope
you really need to do something with your outro. Actual solid outro.
yeah, solid outro is something I have to work on.
Go write some stuff down and practice it in a mirror or something.
All right. Well, in that case, I wish you guys a...
We'll see you guys in the video next. We'll see you guys in the next video.
Yeah, good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye for now.